What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Legend, Legend Purple Way, Legend VZ, however you want to call me, Snowman, all that. And today we back in here doing another video. Today I'm going to show you how to speed up. I'm going to optimize your PC so you guys can play Roblox more efficiently, and I'm going to speed up the process. First thing we're going to do, we're going to go in the Roblox studio. You already know. Pop open this. There we go. File. We're going to go to settings. All right. We're going to start off in game options. Game options have your chat history to 100, your report abuse history to 50, chat scrolling 5, bubble chat max bubbles 3, bubble chat lifetime 30. Scroll down. Video quality, low resolution. Video capture, enable. Lua, 0.299. Wait time buffer, 0.1. Diagnostics. Go down, benchmarking, tick count, precise, override, set that to fast. Go down, physics. Go to physics, environment, throttle, skip 16th. I turned allowed sleep off. You can turn it on if you guys want to. Throttle adjust time 1, scroll down, disable CSGV2, turn that on. All right, studio. You want to, I think there was one setting in here that's more important. Permission level shown game. Here it goes. Runtime undo behavior. Turn that to snapshot. Server audio behavior. It's just a game. Network. Oh, yeah. They changed the network settings. Rendering quality level. Set that to automatic. Edit quality level. Level 2. Eager bulk execution, turn that on. This is your physics. You always want to keep that on. Graphics mode, set it to metal. Now the top three are metal, Vulkan, and OpenGL. You guys can play around with that yourself, but I got to set the metal. Frame rate manager, turn that on. And mesh, cache size, 99999. Task schedule, thread 16. And I was missing one important thing that I didn't show you guys. Hold on. Where are you? Where are you? Camera speed. Set this to 99999. Hit enter. Camera shift speed. Do the same thing. Camera mouse speed 10. Is that it? I think that's it. Let me see. Yeah, this is it. All right, and then you want to just close this out, and then you want to hit restart or restart later. You want to hit restart as soon as you do that. All right, now we're going to get into some settings to just optimize your PC. We're going to go straight into this and make sure you guys can hear me. All right, yeah, we're going to go straight into this. Damn, I'm getting 400 FPS even while... Yo, I'm doing 400 FPS even while I'm... Dang. Even when the game is disabled. Yo, that's crazy. Even with OBS on, I'm still getting 400 frames. So, what you guys want to do, you guys want to, first thing you guys want to do is use the connection unlocker. That's going to be in the description. Execute that. The second thing you guys want to do is download the Leetrix FPS boost. This one and the 481 FPS booster. You guys want to get that. I'm going to leave everything in the description. So you guys, it's a quick, simple download. It's real quick and simple. But then you guys also want to, I got so many programs, man. Then you guys also want to use Quick CPU. I'm just going to give you the more efficient, the stuff that you're going to need. Quick CPU is basically a power. It's like, it just, boosts up your core clock on your CPU. So I set mine the ultimate performance mode, and then I set it as active, but I'll teach you guys how to do that later in the video. So next thing you guys want to do, you guys want to go to your settings. Then we'll start here. We'll go to gaming. So go to Xbox game bar, turn this off. Game mode, turn that on. Next thing you want to do, system. You want to go down, you want to go to notification and actions, turn that off, look at my settings real closely, all that's off, focus and active off, power sleep you set to never, unless you got bad Power settings. Multitasking off. Timeline off. You want to go into the sound. Wait, not here. Sound settings. Ah, control panel. Sound. Now you guys, what you guys want to do, you guys basically want to turn off. Hold on, can you hear me? Testing, 1, 2, okay. Now you guys basically want to go down and you want to disable all of these, all the ones that you don't use disable. So for example, headphones, digital audio, output, only my monitor that gives all audio and my speakers. You want to go click whatever device you use. For example, this, you want to go to properties. Where is it? Did I do it wrong? Oh, I'm sorry. Go to change system sounds. Here it is. Properties. Where is you? Hold on. Give me 1 second. I can never find this thing. Adjust system volume. No, that's not what I need. Manage audio devices. Huh, that's crazy. Ah, this is what I needed. Okay. What you guys want to do, you guys want to go into advanced for whichever sound you're using. It wouldn't let me do that because this one is disabled. But this one, since this one is enabled, you want to set it to 41 hertz. I'm only got mine set to 4800 just for the video. I'm about to set it back down because you don't want your sound drivers, your sound basically, you don't want your sound clogging up all your memory. And what you guys also want to use is latency monitor. Well, Leetrix latency fix, that's one. You guys basically open this app and you hit install. This is the first thing you do once you get a PC because it basically boosts your network connectivity. And what you guys also want to use is latency monitor. You want to go into, and this might actually lag me, I don't know if it will. But go into latency monitor. Okay. Hit this green play button. Let that load up. And I actually really, really love this tool. This tool actually, it shows you like what's taking up space on your PC. 1, 2, or 3, or 4 is always good. Anything above that is terrible. So just make sure and delete some programs in the process. For example, I know my graphics card takes up most of the space, but I got it removed. How I did that, I went into I created a batch file. Where are you? Hold on, let me go to my batch file real quick. And then that's also going to be in the description, and I'm going to teach you guys how to use it. Ooh, we're on a roll today. Go in your C drive, go down, go into Windows. It's going to be in the programs 86. Shout out to Adam X for showing me this. I'm just going to repeat what he says for people who just don't know. And his video will also be in the description as well. Go into program files 86. And it's going to be my driver. My driver's NVIDIA. Where are you? I'm blind. Yeah. And guys, what you guys want to use is the block all script, and you want to put this, you basically want to drag this into your graphics card, and then you want to run it. You want to run it as an administrator. And what that's going to do is going to block your graphics card from hitting your network, basically clogging up your network. That's mainly the experience of lag in game. What you guys also want to do, and I'm going to show you guys this while I'm doing this. No, I'm using a lot of programs. So if I'm laggy on Internet or Edge, then I apologize. And plus, I got my phone hitting my network as well. much FPS do we hit right now? What is this, 400? Yeah, so we're getting around 400 FPS while all this stuff is still on. So, yeah. So another thing that'll boost your FPS that people don't know about is go into Roblox, right? So right-click on the program you use, go to Properties. Go into, where are you? Actually, no. Go right-click on Roblox, go into, where is it? I think it is Properties. Yeah, go into Properties, go into Compatibility Mode, and then always have this on, Disable Full Screen Optimizations, and hit Apply. I think I have it on, I think I have multiple, RBX players, but I think I already have it set on. Yeah, I think I already have it on. But you always want to disable full screen optimization, so when you're in game, don't have it set to the in-game full screen, because it will cause lag. What you want to do is hit Alt and Enter at the same time, so you can still keep your frames. If I just go in here and hit full screen, it's going to be at 300. It's not gonna, you know what I mean? I'm losing frames as I'm here. Now, so guys, what you guys want to do, you want to go, DNS jumper. And this helps. It really helps. It helps your ping, if anything. You want to go to fastest DNS, start DNS test. And everything, all the downloads will be in the description, guys. It's simple. And it'll pick out the fastest fastest DNS server. And you just want to hit apply the DNS server. I don't want to do it because I'm already quick. But yeah, if you're noticing any high ping in game, then yeah. But like I said, guys, the main thing you want to make sure is your FPS, your network received. That's actually the most important. If this turns green, you're basically getting no miles in game. If it goes red, you're going to get mild left and right, especially in the road basketball. I actually noticed it a lot when I'm, you know, even with a high FPS, you still can get mild. You know what I mean? I'm also going to put in a package in the description as well. It'll help your stutters, like a lot of people experiencing a lot of stutter issues on their monitor, and they're not getting as much frames as they need to, but sometimes it's not always your frames, it's just your network. This Roblox runs off the network, and you always want to make sure this is either orange, yellow, or green. Mine's going to turn orange for a little bit, then it's going to pop up green. You'll notice that along in the video, sooner or later. You want to go to Windows, then you want to download Netlimiter. And then, guys, what you want to do, you want to go into Roblox kind. But the first thing you want to do is you want to turn 8-core. Well, I have eight core CPU. But you want to go to where it shows your basically your computer icon. Right click it, add rule, set limit, go to priority, set this to critical, enable it, hit OK. Do that for your network and do that for your internet. And then you want to do that for your Roblox. So you want to go to the Roblox actual game, right click this, add rule, do the same thing, priority, set it to critical. Then what you want to do, you want to go here because this is your network going, I think this one is going in and this one is going out. And guys, what you basically want to do is you want to set this to 40.67 megabytes per second, because that's like literally the max frames. You can set it, I set it for my PC, I set it to 40.67, but for you guys, you guys could probably set it, you know, higher, but I prefer you guys to use 40.67 because that's the fastest for me. But this is megabytes. You can also set it to gigabytes, but seriously, 40.67 will give you like no miles for me. You know, I'm not experiencing any mile issues. You know, this what helps me in game. So set it to 40.67, hit the check mark. If you set it lower, you'll notice a delay. For example, I can actually show you, and this will turn red once I do this as well. Look at this. So if I change this to, let's change it to like, let's say one. Actually, that's not a good fundamental. Let's go down and let's go into KBS kilobytes and let's change this to like 12. And let's turn that off because this is what it should be lagging any moment. Oh yeah, the game froze. Hold on. Let me go to a game where it's active and I can actually, you know, test this. Oh yeah, it can't run because Roblox is hitting the internet, but it so Roblox basically talking to the internet and it's basically lagging me. Hold on, let me actually change that back. 40.67 megabytes per second. Enable. Okay. Enable. And this the page should now run. I don't know. Yeah, it kinda lagged me, I know. It's okay. There it goes. Sorry guys, I just had to kick it back up. Okay. So as you notice, everything's smooth. So I'm gonna have him move around. All right, so I'm gonna have this dude just move around and I'm gonna show you guys what I mean. So if I turn this off, right, everything's still fine. But if I turn this to, let's say 10 megabits. He starts to lag. You know what I mean? So that's what I mean. You're sending the you're sending what goes in and what goes out. So let me turn it back. Let's turn this, and if it gets as it gets worse and worse, let's say I put this to, let's change it to bits. Hold on. Oh, did I hit the? Oh, it's still megabits. Ah, I think he lagged out. I think I crashed. Hold on. Yeah, there it goes. So if I change it as low as I go, this will turn red, is what I'm trying to explain to you. And once that hits red, that means a person can mow me. And that means just because I have high FPS, you know, I'm still going to lag out. You get what I mean? So always keep that to 40.67. Where are you? There we go. And the same for the out, what goes out as well. There. All right. Wait, what is saying client local? Oh, that's the local. Okay, that's fine. All right. So the next thing you guys want to do, you guys want to go into the NVIDIA Pro panel. This is going to take a little while to load. And I'm going to actually go a quick in-depth of what you need to do. So guys, basically what you guys want to do, you want to go to your manage your 3D settings as soon as that opens. And then you guys want to have this your settings as the same as mine. So, excuse me, sharpening, image sharpening, you want to have that off, ambient off, as far as filtering off, if it's a off. Gamma correction on, SLSing mode off, CUDA GPUs all, DSR factors off, low latency mode on, not ultra, because ultra causes lag. You'll notice why if you try it. Max frame rate off, my monitor is G-Sync compatible, multi-frame rate AA off, OpenGL rendering GPU, 1660, well, your graphics card. Power management mode, preferred maximum performance. Preferred refresh rate, highest available, share to catch on, texture filtering, astrophic sample optimization on, text filtering negative LOD bias allow, as we go down, text filtering quality, high performance, texture filtering, trinear optimization on, threaded optimization auto, triple buffering on, vertical sync off, virtual reality preferred rendered frames one, virtual reality variable rate super sampling off. And what you want, guys, also want to do is you want to adjust image sampling. Set this to use the advanced 3D image settings. Well, actually, what I do, I click this, I set the performance, and then I click use, if that makes sense. And it kind of automatically sets the performance there. Click this, go to refresh rate, set it to the highest available. I'm going to teach you guys how to overclock your monitor. And what I mean by that is your monitor won't have, it'll basically, you're upping your hertz, if that makes sense. Let's say I only have a 60 hertz monitor. Yours will probably say 60, right? I can, if you overclock it, and it's safe to do with monitors. If you overclock your monitor, then what you'll get more, basically you'll get more FPS and you'll get more frames. But this is only for some people. Everyone can't do it. I know I tried it. I can't do it. But I'm going to show you how to do that now. So go to change resolution. Go down. Hold on. Is it a change? Huh. That's weird. Where are you? Oh, I'm sorry. Go to, is this it? Cancel. Huh. That's weird. Oh, there it goes. I don't know why I was acting up. This was grayed out. But go to customize. Go to enable resolutions not exposed by a display. Create custom resolution. And guys, what you want to do now, you want to go to where it says your refresh rate. Yours will say 60. You actually want to go up by one and then test it out. If you can go up, keep going up until it shows a black screen. That lets you know your limit, and you always want to have it there because you get way more FPS in game, and you're really not overclocking it. You just up in your hertz, if that makes sense. There's no damage being done unless you go too far, if that makes sense. So you can up it safely. It's fine. I can't go up to one because, you know, like I said again, my monitor just can't handle pushing 241 or 242. But we're gonna close out of there. Now, guys, what you want to do is adjust desktop color settings. You want to go down. You want to have keep your settings as mine. Brightness 60, contrast 42. Well, it just depends on your monitor. But have your digital vibrance all the way up, because this really helps for gamers who are already experienced, if you know what I mean. X this out, and we're gonna keep going to the video. All right. Alright, now what we're gonna do, we're gonna go into your mouse. If you're using a gaming mouse, go set your polling rate to 125. This is only for Roblox. Leave your DPI. I have my DPI high. Some of you guys can't handle it, but go to 125 hertz and set, instead of having your speed all the way up and you're setting your DPI to 400, that's terrible because it basically makes it where your mouse isn't as accurate. You want to set your mouse speed low and your DPI high. That's why there's high DPI for a reason. Now if your polling rate is really really low, and you feel that your mouse isn't as smooth, then you can set it up to 250 or 500. But I don't prefer 1,000 hertz at all. X that off. Now, guys, what you guys want to do then, if you guys are first-person shooters in game, I know some of you guys are. If you want to save a lot more and you don't want to use, like, the inter settings, then you guys can use Borderless Gaming. I recommend it for some of you gamers, but we can go on in the video. So now, guys, what you guys need to do, if I can find it, go to NVIDIA Inspector, and this link will be in the download description as well. Open that up. Click Run. All right, my PC is not overclocked, so just ignore all that. Now, guys, what you guys want to do, you guys want to go down into, where is it? You guys want to click this button. It's right here, this little button right here. All right, now let's get in the fun time of this. So this is going to show pretty much every game possible. So you want to scroll all the way down until you see Roblox. So let's go down. It's going to be hidden somewhere. I probably skipped it. And this is actually going to make you real smooth for the point guards. If I can find it, yo. Here it goes. All right. So you want to set it to the same settings I have it set to. Anti-aliasing, transparency, super set sampling, replay mode all, texture filtering, LOD bias, negative 3.000. You're gonna notice a ton, you're gonna notice a bunch, a huge difference once you set this to negative 3.000. I kid you not. And it like you're like the physics in game, you're basically gonna get no miles off this. This is what helped me a lot. And you're gonna notice it. Scroll down. Set the power management mode when you're playing the game. Set the optimal performance. Like, I kid you not when I say this is going to help you. I already played around with these settings. There's no need for you to try to play around anymore from there. Scroll down from there. Go to SLI rendering mode. Set that to 005. You're going to see it. It's going to be the last one. Scroll down from there. Enable opt application for Optimus. Set that to 08. Go down from there. Maximum frames allowed. Set that to 1. I think they have it. I think they had it preset to 2. Set it to 1. And that's it, guys. And then hit apply once you're done. X that off. All right, yo. I'm telling you, man. So next thing we're gonna do, I think I overlooked this, but we're gonna go into MSI utility. That's what it was. Almost forgot you. Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? And I'm actually gonna download it and show you guys the package. Hold on 1 second, because I actually need this on my PC. Open. Oh, I already have it. Okay, cool. So you guys want to open this up? Right, so here's, oh, my bad. Strike. Hold on, give me 1 moment here. Run as administrator. Nope. Okay, so guys, this is the wrong one. The other one shows the priorities. Give me 1 second while I get that out. I think this is the one, if I'm not mistaken. Well, basically what you will do, I'm gonna have the link. I'm gonna have the link to it anyway. But basically what you guys would do, you would go into MSI utility, you would go to your graphics card. My graphics card is here, and you want to set it to high. And that's the only thing you want to do. You after that, hit apply. Don't do anything else. If you touch anything else, there might be issues with your PC. But you want to have this to high for the best performance and the most out your graphics card. And I'm gonna actually put that in the description. I'm gonna have to find a download link for that because I don't know what's that's going on. But after that, you want to download SpyBot Anti-Beacon? That'll be in the description as well. Open that up. Hit it should be optimize, or I think that's the button. Hit optimize and then close that out when you're done. It's just just pushing the group policies and getting better telemetry out of your system. So next thing what you want to do is download timer resolution. You want to click that, hit run. Then go to maximum, and you always want to have this maximum because this basically syncs your keyboard and mouse better to your PC. What you guys also want to do, I can barely breathe. You guys want to go to and this is for people with who have low RAM or anything like that. You want to go to wise memory, not right now. You want to click optimize, and you just want to optimize it as you go. do this every time you, before you even get on. I personally have Razor, so I really don't even need this program, but this is just another program for you guys if you guys want to use it. It's all good and Gucci. Oh yeah, big plus. Open up download C Cleaner. I actually love this program with a passion. Go into custom clean, and you're gonna notice a huge FPS boost once you do this. Click each and every one of the check marks, and then hit run cleaner. And do the same thing for some of your applications. Besides, do this first. Do this first before you touch anything else. I wouldn't really touch the registry, but if you feel as though everything's not good, this is literally the first thing you want to do before downloading any of my programs that I've told you guys about. Clear the registry first and then download the unlocker and then the Leetrix latency fix and all that other stuff. Go into tools, and here's the most important piece of the puzzle is get rid of the unnecessary tools. You'll see like the phone. You'll see phone in here. Just uninstall your phone. Uninstall anything that you don't need. That's like literally the most important thing. So, for example, let's open up the game now. I have a lot of stuff opened up. That's why I'm having so long. It's just taking up so much space and memory that it can't handle it. But you always want to make sure. Oh, actually, it's... Wise, let me in that. But guys, you always want to make sure your CPU and your memory and your disk is always low. It's under at least 30. If everything is under at least 30 and you're not getting red network received, then you're good. If you're getting red, then that's terrible and something's wrong. Something's most importantly wrong. Now let's go into your Ethernet settings and let's fix up your Wi-Fi and your bandwidth. All right. So we're gonna go into your. For the people that use Ethernet, this is for you guys. I can't go really, really in depth, but I'm gonna try just for the video. All right, so what you wanna do, you guys wanna go into network and sharing center. Cool. Then you wanna go to change advanced sharing, change adapter settings. Click your adapter. This is my Ethernet. Then what you guys want to do, you guys want to go into properties. All right. You guys want to go to IPv4, hit properties. Oh, I already have a custom DNS server. I don't need it. Wow, but it's already there. I'm going to have to change that when I'm done. Set automatically. But that's my DNS. You can set it to mine. It's perfectly cool. But then you guys want to go into advanced and set the turn automatic off, set the interface metric to 1000. That's going to, that's you're going to see a huge difference in your PC connection once you do that. Go to cancel. That's only for the people with Ethernet, by the way. Now, guys, what you guys want to do if you're using Ethernet, go to IPv4, go to properties, not properties, go to configure. Advanced, ARP offload enabled, PME disabled, energy flow efficient off, flow control RX and TX enabled, gigabyte slave mode, let that go to auto, interrupt moderation enabled, interrupt moderation rate adaptive, IPv4 checksum load disabled, jumbo packet disabled, large send offload IPv4 v2 disabled, large send offload v2 for v6 disabled. Go down, log link state event enabled, maximum number of RSS queues, 2 queues. Wait, set this to the highest queue possible, actually. Mine only goes up to 2, but if you guys can go up to like 4 or 6, 4, 5, 6, or however high you can go up to, set that to the highest. NS offload, set that enabled, packet priority, and VLAN enabled. PTP hardware timestamp, disable it. Receive buffers, change it to 256. Receive side scaling, enabled. reduce speed on power down, enabled. You can actually disable that. I don't know why the fuck I have that enabled, but I have mine enabled. Software timestamp disabled, speed and duplex, auto negotiation, TCP checksum offload disabled, TCP checksum offload v6 disabled, transmit buffer 512, UDP checksum offload disabled, UDP checksum offload disabled, wait for link, auto detect, wake on link settings disabled, wake on magic packet enabled, wake on pattern match enabled. All right, guys. Now the next thing we're going to do, we're going to help you get, I said it early in the video, we're going to help you guys get ultimate performance mode. Do not use ultimate performance mode for people with bad laptop batteries. This is not for you. This can actually harm you rather than help you. This is only for people that's typically, they use desktops like me. What you guys want to do, you guys want to go into your battery options, and we're just going to configure a few things. You want basically power options, yeah, and then you want to have it set to ultimate performance. I don't know why I have it balanced. I guess it auto set it me all every time you shut down and shut it back on. You'll have it to you'll have it set to balance, so always check ultimate performance. Now, as you see, you have a bunch of I have a bunch of additional power plans, but Bitsum and Ultimate Performance are the two of my favorites. This one is more for CPU, and this is actually really, really good for gaming, and this is good for gaming as well. So it's kind of like it's pick your poison. So guys, you want to go into change plan, change advanced power settings. You want to just go in and JavaScript time frequency maximum, wireless adaptive mode maximum, maximum process state 100, system cooling policy active, active, minimum processor state 100, time display never, and then that's really all you need. It's all set there, and I'm going to show you guys how to get that in the first place. So what you guys want to do, you want to go into ultimate. You can just type it in on Google, ultimate, and this will be in the description as well, ultimate performance mode, and then click how to enable it, and it'll show you the code somewhere in here. Here it is. Just copy the code, and I'm going to actually paste that all. Actually, going to show you guys how to enable it. Then, guys, what you want to do, you want to open up a command prompt or PowerShell. And then, guys, what you want to do is just paste in the code. Oops, my bad. You just paste in the code, hit enter. And then the code's actually, and then once you hit enter, you'll see, got so many programs open. Once you hit enter, you're gonna go back into battery power options. I'm backtracking. And then go to hide additional plans. And then once you go into hide additional plans, you should see ultimate performance mode right here. And just turn that on. The next thing that another thing that I use typically when I'm gaming, you want to go into we got a few more programs and then we're done. I know it's a lot, but you guys then want to go into park control. And you guys basically want to set this to 200. So if I'm doing real intensive gaming, I will set this to 200. And then hit apply. And then I'll just speed up my cores. And then, hold on 1 second, guys. All right. So then what you guys want to do is set this to ultimate performance mode, or you can set it to the Bitsum highest performance. You will only get this unless you download Park Control. So you can only give Bitsum the option to choose this if you get park, if you download Park Control. And shout out to them because they're really helpful. Now, guys, what you guys want to do? We got a few more on the plate, and we're almost done. Don't hold me on this. You guys want to go into your device manager. You want to scroll down to system devices, and you want to turn in high precision event timer. You want to disable that. This causes a lot of issues in game, and nobody wants issues in game, including me. let's see here. There's a couple more things, and we are Gucci. Oh, yeah. Driver booster. That's last thing. A lot of people don't want a bunch of programs and applications on their PC, and I understand that. But just use the tools I give you. Test them out for your own experiences. If you're not experiencing, if you're still not experiencing up to quality, then use another program, if that makes sense, until you see good results. Just make sure that your drivers are up to date. And mine is cracked. So you guys can just look up driver booster cracked and then find like a cracked version of the thing. And just scan for your drivers. All right, guys. Then guys, what you want to do? You want to update, especially. I actually need to update my network adapters. But you guys just want to update all of your drivers and make sure all of them are today. I'm actually gonna update these when I get done with the video. This is always a little handy tool. And guys, what you also want to do, you can turn game booster on and system optimization optimize if you want to. It's not a big deal, if that makes sense. And I think I covered everything in a time shortly manner. Let me just make sure I'm not missing anything. Oh yeah, Razer Cortex. So let me show you guys how to set this up. So once you open up your, I don't use this at all. I just only use this for the sole purpose. Well, I do use this. I only use this for when I'm in a game. It just optimizes my memory, so I won't have any issues in game or anything. So guys, basically what you want to do, you want to go into, hold on, give me 1 second. You want to go into boost. You want to have an auto boost set. You want to enable your CPU cores, disable CPU sleep mode, turn off automatic updates, clean your RAM, clear your clipboard, enable game power solutions. Actually, I might disable this. That's probably why it keeps changing. Well, disable this thing. But you can have it on if you want to. But you want to go into settings. Where are you? Hold on, guys. Give me a second so I can find it. All right, guys. So basically, what you want to do, you just type in Roblox, and you want to add your own program. So just type in Roblox, copy your program in here. You can do that by Control Alt Delete Task Manager. Go to your game. Go to where is it? Services? No, go to details. Click here, open file location. That's the easy way to do it. And then just copy, go to properties again, and then just copy the program, where the location of the program, and then you just paste it in here. And then you do it, and then you do the same, then you copy the version in here as well. So then you want to go into the, where are you? You want to go into, I think it is, if I'm not SSL, where are the versions of this thing? I haven't touched this in a long, long time. So if I make a mistake, don't hold me on it. Uh, Oh, I'm tripping. I think you can just you can actually just go into the game, go into properties, and it should, if I'm not mistaken, save the versions already. Huh. That's weird. Well, I guess it doesn't do that, but typically you typically would. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. So you would go into the launcher, right click, go into properties, go into your launcher, and then copy the version from here because the launcher is your version. Don't hold me on it. All right, last but not least, before we wrap up the video, and this is another setting that you guys can use. And I'm just gonna end the freaking video because I know you guys are like, dang, Legend, you do all that for your PC. Yeah, I actually do, man. It sucks. But you guys want to go into Windows and you guys want to go into about your PC. Then hold on, that's not it. You guys go to this PC, you right click this PC, you go into properties. You want to go to advanced system settings. You want to go into where it says performance, you want to go settings and adjust it for best performance. Actually, just turn it all off. And if you see anything, only just turn it all off and hit apply. And then you want to also go to check for updates and just make sure your PC is up to date. Now, here's another thing, guys. If you're on Windows 10, my PC is all the way up to date on, I think it's Windows 2004. That's the newest version. Hold on. I think some of you guys might be on 1904. Where are you? Yeah, I'm on version 2004, but some of you guys might be, I think, still on 1909. You guys want to change that and change your operating system, and I'll teach you how to do that in a real quick time. Just go into 2004 ISO, and you guys just basically want to download the ISO files. Where are you? And you just click, I guess you just click here to download the 2004 ISO. And then boom, you're done. And after all that said and done, you'll notice a high FPS in game. And no, I have all these applications open. Matter of fact, even though this is also because I have 8 cores. You know, it benefits me a ton of bunch, you know? But you guys have a good day, and I'll see you on the flip side. Peace. Oh yeah, and last but not least, you need RBX FPS unlocker. To up basically boost your frames, and you also want to use a game booster as well. You just want to have it set to super boost. You can config you can boost it all the way up to super boost, but I'm not gonna do it for this video. And yeah, that's it, guys. Like I said, if you guys know any other methods that you guys want to share with other people, go ahead and feel free to share it. I know it's a lot, and I know, you know, I said I was gonna end the video, but yeah, I'm in the video. All right, peace.